Hi everyone, welcome to Revel in Row. My name is Michelle and today I'm going to be talking to you about my first tattoo. So I just got my first tattoo last month at the beginning of August and I have been wanting a tattoo for so long. I thought my first tattoo was going to be a rose on the inner part of my arm because that's something that I've been wanting since maybe last January, so like January 2017. I knew that I had to think about it before I made the decision because obviously a tattoo is forever, so I wanted to make sure that it was something that I really, really wanted. And then a couple months ago, at the beginning of summer, my best friend and I decided to get matching tattoos. Her and I are very similar in a lot of ways. Our friendship kind of blossomed because we both deal with really bad anxiety. We really wanted to get something that represented our friendship, that represented how we've grown from our anxiety, and just kind of like a reminder to stay calm and a reminder of how much we've grown. So we decided to get matching lavender tattoos. Lavender because it's calming, and then we got two stems that kind of intertwine to represent our friendship. I absolutely love it. And this is a design that we had seen on Pinterest, online. We've seen a couple different versions of it and we just kind of came up with a design that we liked and then we kind of changed it a couple times. And when we went to go get the tattoo, we changed it a couple times with the artist as well to kind of just make it perfect for us. So where did we get it done? We got it done in LA. I did a lot of research as far as like which tattoo shop I wanted to go to. I didn't just want to walk into a tattoo place and just get it done. I really wanted to make sure we were going somewhere where every artist was absolutely amazing. And we chose Generation 8 Tattoo in LA. I had seen amazing reviews about them. I didn't see any bad reviews. I got to see a lot of their artwork. Everything looked amazing. Every artist there looked so talented based off of the work that I saw. And when I made the appointment, I realized I didn't specify who I wanted to work with, which made me anxious when I got to the tattoo parlor. But they set us up with a guy named Song, and he was incredible. He made me feel really comfortable. He worked with us and really helped us, you know, edit the design best fit for us. He probably went back to draw it like 3 or 4 times. He was just really patient with us overall, and like I didn't feel rushed. He was just genuinely so nice. He made it a really great experience for us. So she went first. I joked around saying that I was glad that she went first because then he could perfect the design. So by the time he worked on me, it would be amazing. So my turn came around. He, you know, placed a design on me. And if I didn't like it, he like would take it off. And then he gave me the design and let me place it where I wanted, which I really loved. I loved that he did that because then I got to look in the mirror and I was like, okay, this is perfect. Like, I like the way that it looks. I know that I did it. I like that he gave me that little bit of control as far as like the tattoo placement goes. Did it hurt? Yes. It wasn't terrible. It did feel like a cat scratch. It was a single needle though, so I can't say that like anything bigger than this or anything that isn't a single needle doesn't hurt 10 times more. The like straight line, like a consistent line, was definitely painful, but like the little individual petals, like every time he finished one and it started to hurt, it would stop because then he would start a new petal. So it wasn't terrible, but it was painful. It was mostly painful also around like the closer it got to my wrist bone. I would probably never get anything shaded or anything huge because I would not want to sit through that for very long. So I think any tattoo I get from here on out will be a single needle tattoo. As far as the aftercare, like taking care of your tattoo, that's something I really wanted to cover in today's video because I had my tattoo done at night and I came home at about 11, 1130 at night. My tattoo's all wrapped up. They give you a care package when you leave and it was kind of like just little instructions, and then it gave you like a little petroleum jelly that had like vitamins A and E or C or something to keep the tattoo moisturized. So I got home and I'm reading the instructions and it says to take off your bandage in 2 to 6 hours. Well, it was 11:30 at night, it had already been 2 hours, and in 6 hours, it would be like 4 o'clock in the morning, so I started to freak out that I'd have to wake up in the middle of the night and clean it. I didn't want to leave it on for longer than it said to, and so I called the place. because I'm insane. Guy on the phone did have a really thick accent. I think he was German or something. Super nice, but I couldn't understand him, and I didn't want to keep asking him questions because I couldn't understand him, and I didn't want him to repeat himself. So it's just like, okay, thanks. And then I hung up. I was like, I have no idea what to do. So I started texting like my brother and my cousin, like how to take care of this, and everybody was telling me different ways to take care of it. So that just didn't calm my nerves. I felt like nobody knew what they were talking about. So then I started YouTubing it and Googling it. And again, I'm just getting a bunch of different instructions on how to take care of it. I talked to my friend who got the tattoo, and she told me how she was taking care of it. And basically it was up to my discretion. Either I could leave it on all night while I was sleeping, or I could take it off and clean it before. I was really worried that if I left it on, that the tattoo would be too moist and that it would ruin the tattoo. So I opted to take off the bandage and clean it. I was just really worried about taking off the bandage before I went to bed because I was worried that like while I slept that like it would get infected. I have cats, so I was worried that like their hair or dandruff, or if the cat got on me, they would scratch it. Like all these things. Also, I didn't have the right soap to take care of it. It said like a non-fragrant soap. So I went to Target and I ended up getting a Dove soap. I initially got like a baby Dove soap to use, and I realized later the next day that it had like a scent to it. So I stopped using that, and my friend told me to get a Dial soap bar because there's no fragrance in it. I mean, it was really inexpensive. The only thing is they didn't sell individual ones, so I had to buy a huge pack, so now I've got enough soap to last me a lifetime. Basically, I just took off the bandage, I would wash my hands, I would take the soap and wet my hands a little bit, and then rub my hands into the soap, and then wet my hands again so that was kind of soapy and wet. And then I would wash my tattoo very lightly, just like in circular motions. Then I would rinse my hand and kind of cup it and get some water, and I would rinse it off and take off all the soap. And then I would get a clean paper towel and I would just pat it dry. And that's just kind of what I did every morning and every night. And then I would use that jelly that they gave me 2 to 3 times a day. A couple steps that I did incorrectly that I think caused my tattoo to be lighter. First was the first time I washed my tattoo, I held the paper towel too tightly on my tattoo, so when I took the paper towel off, I could see like ink on the paper towel. So I would suggest lightly patting it, do not hold it tight. So I think that caused my tattoo to be a little bit lighter because my friend's is still like perfectly dark. On top of that, I wasn't really good about keeping it moisturized. I did do it 2 times a day, but I would suggest like anytime it's dried up, put the jelly back on. Like if your skin has soaked it up, just put more of that stuff on. Keep it moisturized. That's so important. So I think that like mine scabbed more than it should have. I think that may have caused it to dry up a little bit as well. But it's healed fine. And the tattoo shop also said like if you need touch-ups, you have free touch-ups for the rest of your life. So if I ever wanted to go back and get anything touched up, I absolutely could. So I would say if you're gonna get a tattoo and you're looking for ways to keep it clean, use the jelly that they give you, or there's really great jellies that they have like online. I'll go ahead and link some options down below. And this Dial soap was, I think, the easiest and best option. I would ask, you know, the tattoo shop how they suggest to keep it clean. Each place is going to tell you different because each person experiences, you know, different methods of keeping it clean. This was just the method that worked best for me and the method that I'll probably use like going here on out with every tattoo that I end up getting. A tattoo cost about $80 prior to tipping. I'm absolutely in love with it. If you're looking for a great place to get it done and you happen to be in California or near LA, I would highly suggest Generation E Tattoo. I will be going there for every tattoo going forward. I just had such a great experience and I really trust them. I'm really, really happy with it. I'm excited to get more. We'll see. If you guys have any questions about tattoos, or if you want to let me know what kind of tattoo that you're interested in getting or hoping to get, I would love to know. Feel free to leave me a comment down below. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Bye.